ערב שבת שלום to all our viewers. פרשת השבוע, פרשת פנחס. פנחס בן אלעזר בן אהרון הכהן השיב את חמתי מעל בני ישראל בקנאו את קנאתי בתוכם ולא חיליתי את בני ישראל בקנאתי. פנחס בן אלעזר בן אהרון הכהן, פנחס the son of אלעזר, the grandson of אהרון הכהן, השיב את חמתי מעל בני ישראל. הקדוש ברוך הוא said that he was very upset and פנחס יקם הקדוש ברוך הוא דן. What's the reason? Because that he killed זמרי בן סלו and כוזבי בצור that did bad things that we don't need to explain now. חכמים said פנחס הוא אליהו. פנחס is אליהו, it's the same person. But we need to understand what is פנחס to אליהו. How we got from פנחס to אליהו is more than 500 years between them. How we explain that פנחס הוא אליהו. Also we know that פנחס, he passed away, he died. And אליהו, he went up to שמיים. So how we can explain this conflict? And why Chachamim, they felt necessary to explain that Pinchas or Eliyahu. And there is a big lesson that we're going to learn from this video today, Be'ezrat Hashem. Pinchas or Eliyahu, Rabotai, Pinchas, he had a midah, a character trait. Kin'ah. Kin'ah is a jealousy. But there is a good jealousy, and there is a bad jealousy. חכמים told us in פרקי אבות, קנאת סופרים תרבה חוכמה. A person that is jealous from a סופר. סופר is a person that's learning Torah or learning any book. When you're jealous from a smart man, you will be smart. קנאת סופרים תרבה חוכמה. So there's good jealousy, there is bad jealousy. There's bad jealousy when we look at our friends, the houses, the cars, the money, the good life that they have. This is a wrong jealousy. But there is a good jealousy. And the good jealousy is when you jealous for good things. But there is also different jealousy when you jealous for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. When you see someone that he doing the opposite, not because that he have a desire, because that he love to do the opposite from what the Torah telling us. This is called Mored, a person that is Mored Bakadosh Baruch Hu. There was one person, his name Zimri ben Salu. He went to Moshe Rabbeinu and told him, Moshe, your wife, she's Midianit, right? Who gave you permission to marry her? And if no one gave you permission to marry her, what's the problem? That I'm gonna marry with the Midianit? That I'm gonna sleep with the Midianit? It's the same thing. Moshe Rabbeinu didn't know what to answer. And all Am Yisrael was sitting there, very nervous, confused, very strong question. Someone asking Moshe Rabbeinu, who gave you permission to marry the Midianit? She's not from Am Yisrael. It's not a question. We know that it's not a question. Because Moshe Rabbeinu, he married Sipora before Matan Torah. But now, after that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave us the Torah, there is no permission to marry with a Goya, with non-Jewish. But another answer we have, that Zimri ben Salu didn't want to sleep only with this girl, only to marry her. He just wanted a permission to be with any girl, any Goya, has b'shalom. So this is very bad. And Pinchas ben Elazar ben Aharon HaKohen, he couldn't stand it. He was jealous to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, jealous to Moshe Rabbeinu. And he went, he killed Zimri ben Salom. There is a very similar story about jealousy with Eliyahu HaNavi. That Eliyahu HaNavi said to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, כנו קינאתי לאדוני בתפארה. אני מקנא לך השם. I'm jealous for you. I cannot see that עם ישראל, they're not listening to you, והם עוברים עבירות. This is the reason that Eliyahu took the key of the rain and didn't give עם ישראל a rain for 3 years. And then הקדוש ברוך הוא ask Eliyahu, please, בניי צריכים לגשמים. בניי need water. Even if they wrong sometimes, but they're making teshuva. Not all of עם ישראל רשעים חס ושלום. You have to take it to consideration too. And Eliyahu, he told HaKadosh Baruch Hu, no. Ki avru et beritecha. Hem lo shomrim et haberit. They not mekayem et haberit. Amar lo HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he told him, Eliyahu, hayecha. You're going to go to every brit of Am Yisrael. This is the reason that now in the beritot we have a chair, a special chair for Eliyahu Navi. Why we have a special chair for Eliyahu Navi? Because to invite Eliyahu to see that we are mekayem et haberit. We follow the berit, we follow HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the laws of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Even the Hilonim, even people that are non-religious, they also mekayem et haberit. There is people that have some desire about Shabbat, about tefillin, about tefillot, but berit milah, everybody do. This is the comment between Eliyahu Navi and Pinchas. But there is something here. HaKadosh Baruch Hu and his Torah, we said, Ineni noten lo et beriti shalom. HaKadosh Baruch Hu giving the shalom, peace to Pinchas. Not just peace. Beriti shalom meaning that Pinchas will be the Kohen for generations. His kids going to be Kohanim and his grandkids going to be Kohanim forever. But the problem that and the word shalom in Sefer Torah, if you see, is going to be Vav Keti'a. Vav Keti'a is like half a Vav. Missing the leg. What's the reason? Because at Pinchas he had to kill to make shalom in Am Yisrael, to stop the magifa. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu don't want that is going to be the first priority. It should be the second or the third or the fourth priority. Even if sometimes you need to kill, don't go straight to kill. Don't go straight to make bad things. Yani for people it's bad things. Try to do it with Darkei Shalom, with Darkei Noam. Eliyahu Navi, same thing you. You had to go to Am Yisrael and try to talk to Am Yisrael and try to be Mekarev Am Yisrael. Pinchas, same thing you. Maybe if you're going to Zimri ben Salu, you're going to talk to him in a nice way. Maybe he will stop. Maybe Am Yisrael will stop from making Ba'ayot and Hataim. This is not the derech to kill. This is not the derech to embarrass people. Right, sometimes we are very hot temperature we have, and we are jealous for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and we angry. But it's not supposed to be the first priority. This is the reason that the shalom, it's not shalem. The shalom, the peace that Pinchas is supposed to get, it's a half. It's not the first priority in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Same thing you, Eliyahu. You told HaKadosh Baruch Hu that Am Yisrael not keeping the berit? No problem. You're right. But maybe you can do something else to be mekarev Am Yisrael. Not Chas v'Shalom, to let him go. This is the reason that now the punishment of Eliyahu Navi is that you have to go to every brit milah to see that Am Yisrael still close to Hashem. Even if we're not so religious, even if we're not so tzaddikim, but still we are trying, at least we try to be mekayem the mitzvot. Rabotai, from here we learn something very important, few things. First, when you see someone, your family, they're not going in the right direction, they're not so religious, maybe you want to tell them something, try to do it b'darcheha darchei noam echol n'tivoteha shalom, in a nice way, first. And never give up. Never give up. Never said, you know what, this guy, he don't have a future. Chas v'shalom. You have to try to do it b'derechei adarchei Noam and never give up from no one from Am Yisrael, no Yehudi. And try to be mekarev every Yehudi to Aviyem Shebashamayim, the way how Pinchas did and the way how Eliyahu Anavi did. Just they did it in a different way. We have to try to do it in the nicest way, b'ezrat Hashem. Shiyeh Shabbat Shalom lekol Am Yisrael. הן בשורות טובות.